What is the difference between objective and non-objective law, and what are the consequences in society of each?
That is one of the most important questions today. An objective law is a law which defines objectively what constitutes a crime or what is forbidden, and the kind of penalties that a man would incur if he performs the forbidden action. Objective means definable, graspable by a rational consciousness. Therefore, an objective law would be a law which a man can understand and apply, so that every man ahead of committing an action would be able to tell what is the crime forbidden, what penalty would he incur if he commits it, and can make a decision accordingly. To be a law-abiding citizen, he should be able to understand the law and apply it as guidance to his own social actions. Now, a non-objective law is one which cannot be defined. It means a law without specific definition, which may have as many different interpretations as there are men. Under a non-objective law, a citizen cannot tell what is permitted or forbidden. He cannot tell what action is socially accepted, what action will be punished, and what will be the nature of the punishment. A non-objective law is left strictly at the interpretation of the authorities, usually the judges. Under dictatorships, it would be the commissars. But in any case, a non-objective law is one which a man cannot interpret himself, a law that is not defined and is in fact undefinable. The best example of it is, of course, antitrust legislation, where a man cannot tell actually what is permitted to him, what is forbidden, and may commit a legal crime without knowing that he's doing it.